Warped Tour 2012, and Ernie Ball was a sponsor, and I remember it was actually the first time that I ever got to play Music Man at one of the tents that they had there where they have the instruments set up, and I just went around and just started jamming on it, and I really liked it. And it wasn't until this year, 2013, that I went to the tent again, and I actually asked if I could use one for a couple of shows. My foundation for playing bass started when I was, you know, about 14, 15 years old, and a lot of my early influences actually played Stingrays. You know, I have this DVD at home of Flea, and he's doing a bass tutorial, and he's got a black Stingray, and you know, John Barry used to play them, and so did Mark Hoppus as well when he started off. So the thing that I really like about the Stingray is that for our style of music, our new stuff is kind of getting a bit heavier now. It's just got a really nice natural attack to it, you know, so that when you're getting a lot more bottom end, you're not losing the string attack that you really like and that you like to hear when you're playing. I specifically use their power Slinkys that go up to 110 gauge on the bottom string, just so that when we drop tune, it doesn't lose its brightness. My approach for playing Tonight Alive is I try and get a really good tone, first of all, because I think that's the most important thing. And I just kind of keep it simple, you know what I mean? My life completely changed when I found music, and specifically the bass for me, and then actually playing in a band. I found real friendship, I found like my passion in life, and you know, it really just gave me so much drive to chase dreams that, you know, that I felt like I could achieve. In a way, we've already started doing that for some kids, but my goal ultimately is just to keep doing that for people.